Operations report. Detected. Repairs complete. PT boats are back. Some of them. Kill credit. Contact report. Contact report. Submarine supposedly hit. Contact report. Contact report. Recon. Tanjung Pinang. Recon. Shimonoseki. Contact report. Contact report. Shimonoseki again. Transports moving the wing to Okayama. Uh-oh, Santee is flooding again. Damn it! She's a real hard luck ship trying to get back from Kochi. Repairs complete. Kochi expands to 8. That means the aviation squads are doubled in effectiveness. Winton increases to 1. Good. Replacements taken. Oh, hey! So it looks like all those oilers and other ships that needed refit can get refit at Kochi. Once, of course, looks like the airfield had to get up to size 8 first. Now, how does an airfield expansion trigger a shipyard activity? Dumb as heck, I think. That's just silly. Well, expansion. Now we don't have to take the oilers back down to Pearl Harbor. Okay. PT boat starts refit. Upgrades. Upgrades. Reinforcement, Los Angeles. Astoria. Oh, 2 more transport squadrons arriving at in eastern U.S. and an aviation battalion at Seattle. Hong Kong, we have our 4 PT boats in repair. I will take the couple of these damaged ones. I'm going to send them back into the dock for repair as well. Quick repairs. The enemy, of course, now that we have air cover over Chow Chow, won't attack Chow Chow. Typical cowards. So I'm going to pull out these Aero Cobras. We're going to wait for the recovery, and then I'm going to pull out the Aero Cobras and replace them with some Chinese Vanguard for night coverage. Same here, we're going to pull out the Warhawks and leave 1 squadron of Hurricanes and an element of Vanguards to provide night cover. Shanghai, we have Sea Raven is returned. Off we go to Shikoku Station. Fusan, the attack did not go into Kobe, mainly probably because the detection was too low. Like, cowardly! Incompetent! Recon boys. So instead of sending 1 flight, I have to send the entire freaking squadron after these guys. So we're sending the whole squadron to... Oops, that's Shimonoseki. What happened here? Well, let's change this. Let's send the whole squadron for Kobe. Maybe we'll get the attack tonight. These guys flew yesterday, so I'm going to let them rest today. Fatigue level 1. I don't know, that's a whole squad. This is a... sending a squadron of 6? I don't know. Maybe that'll be enough to trigger the attack. We're still conducting recon on Shimonoseki. Just because once we destroy all of Tsushima, the next target will be Shimonoseki. Well, because of the recon incompetence, the bombers... Well, they're already... We're sending everybody. All the fortresses, all the liberators, Navy liberators. Even the Brit liberators are going to go. And the Ventura are going to give it a try. At a level 1 fatigue, sure. We'll try for them. And the Mitchells. So, if it flies, it's going to be spectacular. tanks have moved out, and we're now moving in on Matsui from the east. The Burmese unit moving up to cut off to the northwest is going to be a little bit late. I don't think it'll get there next turn, so we may have to wait a turn on Matsui. The tanks that came out of Takamatsu have arrived, and looks like the AI has decided the fastest route is from Takamatsu up, across, and then over the top to Matsui. So we'll let them go. The infantry has not yet arrived. The infantry has arrived at Okayama, the 32nd Division. I'm putting them into combat mode in case of any counterattack from the enemy moving. Oops, what am I saying? Yeah. In case of any counterattack from Kobe. You can see a little red dash moving. Something is moving to the east, to Osaka. But nothing is moving in the direction northwest. Well, not that I can see, at least. Regardless, I'll keep the infantry division here. It's recovering a little bit. It has almost 400 assault value, so it's a good basis. The other ones are moving up to Matsui to lay siege or help with the attack. The bomber command aviation squads are moving to the southwest, trying to win this last red hex side and seal in the enemy trapped on Takamatsu. Many of the armored units moving out of Kochi have arrived and are bolstering the defense of Takamatsu. It doesn't look like they're needed. The marine divisions and the six infantry divisions are leaving and should arrive at Fukuyama next turn. Did I order them all? Yes, they're ordered all the way to Matsui, so they'll probably take the same route across, like a reverse Z. Up, down, and up again. The enemy, so now that I know that some of these tankers are able to upgrade, I might as well just upgrade them here. I still have to unload them in order to upgrade, but hey, at least you can upgrade here. I don't have to run all the way with the hassle of running all the way back. So we unload them, reload them. Well, at least there's no loss from unloading and reloading. The AI continues to try to bomb these ships, which makes them good targets. Hell of a risky target. Once I unload these babies, I think I'll use one of the minesweepers or something more expendable than an AO for a target. I'll put something up here. I might even bring the PT boats over so that the AI can try to bomb them. Those would be the ultimate expendable units with only one victory point each. But we're chewing up the enemy as he tries. So this is a good training base for fighters as the enemy comes in and gets just annihilated. We are still being worn down slightly, but we have with reserve fighters, we are able to maintain 8 in operation at all times. The real perplexing question is, why are the AOs allowed to upgrade here when the base is size 5, port is size 5, and we've just gotten to airfield capacity 8. While I tried the same orders, here's a level, here's a port capacity 5, airfield level 8. And I couldn't upgrade the AOs on Guam. Just another one of those, what the frick happens in this game? Okay, so I'm going to, see, these, they wouldn't upgrade over here. Required the same thing, 5 and 21. And they even had all the naval support. They had 1,000 naval support here, and we couldn't do it. Okay, I'm going to try it again. I'll leave it down here. The AOs, once we refuel the inbound transport group, I will defuel them, unload their fuel, and I'll try to upgrade them again here. If they don't, then I'll send them all the way back to Pearl Harbor. Another note, Even though we have all the army guys out of Nason, still can't get 20,000 in supplies here. Just cannot win for trying. I've even gotten on hoarding supply. Stockpiling doesn't help. At least we're out of the red. Let's see. Well, we'll see how long it takes. Northern China, I've decided I'm going to use the army sitting in the field here. What's the point? The army up here and the army of Korea, I'm pulling them back. We're gonna march for the field here. Maybe we get there, maybe we don't. It's almost like an army marching around all for the looking for something to eat, because we sure as hell can't use them anywhere else, and they are pretty much pointless. So maybe if I bring them back here, it'll be closer to the supply in India. Hell, after we destroy this unit, this pocket in Akyab, I might just move them all over to Europe, just because there's 4 million supply points at Bombay. They can eat all they want. Not worry about it. Just to get them out of the way. Hell of a way to fight a war, isn't it? Okay, we still have your Indian units moving up on the back roads on the, you know, on the rail cars. Anything? Oh, here's another one heading for Bangkok. Okay. That's kind of silly. Keep him on the railroad here. He was trying to go up to the back roads again. That's kind of silly behavior. At Bangkok, right, we have the 9th Indian getting on the train, getting ready to transfer. No aircraft ready to go. Nothing happening in Singapore, just bombing bases. Bombing bases, nothing up, nothing new. Nothing new at Mulmian. Still waiting for the rest of this wing unit to arrive before we go. No new reinforcements at Chuebo or Imphal. We have another ship back. Okay, everything's already loaded. All the ground units are ready to go. We're going to start up the continuous supply again. Use the Washingtonian. Head for Rangoon. Continuous supply. Go the direct route coastal. Off you go. No additional reinforcements at Calcutta. Here's that engineering aviation we're sending down to Chittagong. Quiet over in Ceylon, nothing happening. Bombay, transports arrived, just unloading two more. No additional reinforcements here. The unit, I tried to make this go to Agra. Oh, for the love of God. It just refuses to go through the middle here. Okay, fine, whatever. Whatever. Okay, screw that. Just go down to Chittagong. Stop wasting my time. Abaddon. Loading. Convoy still loading. No additional reinforcements at Aden. Oh, here comes another convoy inbound tanker from Abaddon. Convoy inbound at Cape Town, but no additional reinforcements. Doing a submarine check. No, well, Capelin was damaged. Okay, Capelin is, no, this is just wear and tear. He got hit once, but it's mostly wear and tear. I'll leave it on patrol for now. Checking the Endurance. Scorpion is already returning. Flying Fish returning. Finback, Albacore, Hake, Spearfish. Ah, Permit. Call Permit back. And Tunny. Come on back. Torpedo check. Pickerel and Gar both had failed attacks. But they still have weapons, so I'm going to leave them on station. Maybe they can redeem themselves with a better attack this turn. Off the Gold Coast, we have two submarines detected. Two submarine groups detected. This says two. Maybe that's a midget submarine carrier again. But all we can do is hope for the best. If they intercept, they intercept. Winton has increased to level 1. Good. We can stop that now. Let's get these guys out of here. I'm going to move over to Hewenden. Maybe we can help bolster this base. Let's just get it up before we leave. It only takes one day to move over and one day down. And we still want to build Emerald to a level 1 before we get out of here. Okay. The base forces moving out from Western Australia, even though they're on the railroad, this place is just so damn big. They have a hell of a long journey. Oh gosh, if they're only moving nine hexes a day or so, that could still take over a week to get over up to Townsville. At Brisbane, we have some tankers in. As they unload, I'm going to switch them off with some other tankers that are repaired and unload it into the base. So we'll give them a chance to unload these guys. Boy, it takes a long time. We already have two more tanker groups coming in. While these guys are empty, I'll try to repair them so that we can send them home in a pristine shape. We better send some escort. These guys move very quickly at a rate of 14 knots. 14 and 14 knots here. Yeah, these guys could be on top of us within a turn, with well within the submarine danger zone. The retrieval convoy has gone past and detected, what's that, a minesweeper, a PT boat, a landing barge, and a midget submarine. I don't think they're all together. There must be some misidentification there. A submarine, well, it just says that there's a midget submarine in the hex. Doesn't mean that there's actually in the same task force. Okay, what we're going to do here is I'm going to form up an air combat mission. We're going to take the two carriers. I'll take the lower ones, the British destroyer escorts. And you know what? I'm going to send them. Let's put a patrol up. I want to put them here and here. Why? These guys have torpedo bombers. I would hope that they will attack the enemy. Should I go 20%? I think I'll set all torpedo bombers in this for 20%. With a little luck, they will attack and sink those buggers. They've somehow sailed past. I don't know where they're going. Moving to the east? Is it moving? Are they trying to resupply truck? I don't know. I'll let the transports sail on a little bit by themselves. There's no real air threat. I think they're pretty much out of range of, yeah, they're out of range of truck. Even if truck somehow gets some supplies and comes up, they should still be okay. So let's see if we can't hunt down this little task force. Panama, we still have the Cape Fear on her final day of loading. I am redirecting her. I'm going to go to Pearl Harbor instead. Why? Because there's a couple of anti-aircraft artillery units here. It's a small detour. We'll go off, we'll dump off at and maybe pick up one of those if we're still needed. Pearl Harbor, we have one transport group has unloaded and is heading back. So we'll turn on the refuel. Out you go. Another one going out. Two are coming in. Wow, look at these guys move. When they finish unloading, these guys just at a rate of 20 knots, 21 knots, they just move like a son of a gun. No aircraft transferring through Pearl Harbor. At Pearl Harbor, the Dunlop has returned damaged. Okay, can we get her into the shipyard? Yes. Hell, we can even put her on critical. She doesn't deserve it. First of all, we're going to have a board of inquiry into the poor ship handling that caused a collision. I wish I could shoot some of these things. Simoon is finishing her refit. So that's one. There are three anti-aircraft artillery units that I have here, but one is going to withdraw after 111 days. It may not be worthwhile taking. Still, if I have the ship, why not take it? It's cannon fodder. It's going to be withdrawn regardless. We have tenders moving past, in and out towards Iniwitok, and the damaged LSTs returning. Ramilies is returning for her refit. On the west coast, we have Los Angeles has 4 transports arrived. We will load these guys. Let's see. Yep, transport. Got to make sure that none of these are requiring upgrades. Some they've been showing up needing upgrades on the very first day, which is I find a little bit silly. Okay, we're sending them off to Iwo Jima. Said it before, I'll say it again. It's a nice straight shot out. Almost like Los Angeles, well, this was built this way. Look at that. One down and bam, all the way out. We have another group loading at San Francisco. We'll take, oh gosh, they're almost finished loading. A little bit more. Let's see, anybody else to go with them. These are all damaged, so we're not going to send them. We'll send the 2 more. Let them load and go together. Oh, I won't unload at Iwo Jima. No ground units ready to go for transference. No air units ready for transference. Another yard minesweeper appears at Astoria. We'll form her up, send her to meet and merge with the training group. Oops. Oops, oops, wrong one. That's a transport group. And merge. Holy cow, a large number of transports have returned. We'll be repairing them and sending them back down to Pearl. In the east, we have 2 more, two more transport squadrons. Okay, we'll set them to train, down, all transports. We'll grab some extra pilots and send them over to San Francisco for transshipment. Over on the islands, we're still unloading some. Another Pioneer group from New Zealand is unloading. The ones that have unloaded, make sure that we turn on their... Where are they now? Ah, right. Turn on their upgrades and reinforcements. I think that was all of them. Ah, here's some more. Pioneer, right? Where else though? Just keeps... Okay. Well, screw that. In this, we have detected an enemy submarine. Damn it. Moving to the northwest. He's moving right across my intake and right across my convoy lanes. So I'm going to have to move these sub chasers to change the patrol over to the southeast side. And they're not going to get here in time, so I'm going to have to break out a bunch of the destroyers and whatnots I have at Guam. And we'll send them off to anti-submarine patrols over here. The first group of cruisers and destroyers have returned, and I've managed to drop them into to repair. So, yeah, it's going to work out well. They should repair in 1 day, so that'll make room for the other ones coming back needing more repair too. On Iwo Jima, we're loading the last Engineering Aviation Battalion for transfer to Hajima, and then we're heading back to Guam. Unfortunately, these ships, my screw up by putting these ships here, they're not able to bring supplies or troops to Japan. My mistake. I should have used more of the AKs and less of the troop and assault transports. I didn't think they would go in, and I thought they'd have time, but I guess not. Okay, here's the damaged carrier still limping back, but all the other ones are making good speed. We haven't encountered that submarine that was over here, so either it was sunk or back to base. Either way, it's not a hassle for me. Oh, what's this one? Oh, here's another. Sorry, I must have forgotten this one. I missed it. Okay, we'll move another sub chaser out to the southeast in hopes of intercepting this submarine. I could chase after these guys with the carriers, but I'll just let it go. Yeah, I don't. Even if he has some supplies here, it's like bringing back a dead body. If he can ram some supplies into a truck, he might be able to get some activity. But I think that the troops here will probably just suck up the supply so quickly that he won't actually have a chance for any air operations. That's my guess, anyway. Oh, one last thing I forgot. My P-38 Echoes here, they're all restored. Restored? Fine, restored. We're ready to strap on the tanks and send them off to Guam. One giant leap. Air raid, Kobe. The bombers are in. No defense. No hits either. Kobe bombed again. Nothing. Bombed third times. Nothing. One interceptor, I guess. The Irvings are out. Hitting a whole hell of a lot of nothing. Wow. Looks like we'll fly it again. The weather might be playing a role in this. Severe storms, totally blind. We got absolutely nothing for that night's effort. Wonder how many bombers will die for it. Ah! We have an encounter. Is it a bombing effort? No airstrike. Was surface combat? The light carriers seem to have bumped into something. Air attack. Ciao, ciao. The air cobras and the hurricanes intercept. Oh, we lose one, but shoot down three. Yeah, the air cobras are my training squadron, so they're not very effective. Still, we lost one. Stupid. Air attack, Tanjung Pinang. Bombing practice, Akyab. Tanjung Pinang, bombed again. One squad destroyed. Bombed again, another squad destroyed. Air raid, Kochi, against the task force. That's 20, much smaller aircraft, much smaller raid. We shoot down six. Oh, for the love of God. And we didn't even bother bombing Tsushima. Oh, for the love of God. You lazy bastards. What the heck is going on? We've total miss on Kobe and no bombing at all at Tsushima. Air Force must have taken the day off. Bombardment, Takamatsu. We lose more vehicles, more tanks probably. Just my luck, typical. Well, the sooner we wipe them out, the happier I will be.